Good morning, everybody. I got a pretty great starting hand here, don't I? Almost want to headline desalinization and take France with duck and cover. I think it's pretty good to hold 5-year plan here, so I really prefer to hold that instead of destalinization. I kind of don't like that last play, actually, cooing in Vietnam. I think I should have cooed Iran instead, or maybe even Italy. Yeah, I think that probably would have been a lot smarter. He's playing it like he's got Asia scoring in his hand. Another thing I could do is just take South Korea with nuclear test ban, which would have also given me Asia domination back. Yeah, I don't really like that last play anymore. I think that was a mess up by me. Maybe I should have put that in India instead of Pakistan there. Because if he coups me hard enough, I lose my adjacency here. But yeah, I think it would have been smarter to put it in India instead of Pakistan on second thought. He must have a pretty low op hand if he could only put two in there. You know, if this turn ends at DEFCON 4, I would have a huge realign opportunity at the beginning of next turn with +1 in West Germany and then +0 Italy. Also, South Africa with +0 is decent. I really want to put this in Zaire, but I also want it in India. You know, I also want it in France. In fact, France is really huge here because if he breaks it and the DEFCON goes back to 5, you know, I can't really. It messes up my realign and it sets him up for a huge realign or Truman Doctrine. I have to put the last one here, even though I really don't want to. kind of left myself open for a lot of things here. I mean, I'm open to IP war. I left myself open in South Korea. I left myself open here. I mean, I had a lot of ops, but it just, I guess I really made a mistake when I couped in Vietnam. Although I guess I did end up using the extra ones for the destall anyway. I still don't like that play. I think that was a mistake to coup in Vietnam, even with the Vietnam revolts up. I could have just taken some. I could have just taken out of Poland for the destalinization or out of Yugoslavia. Anyway, I'm going to plan on holding 5-year plan again, but I don't want to hold it. I probably don't want to hold it at the end of turn 3, because holding it at the end of turn 3 creates kind of a DEFCON problem. Especially if you have cards like CIA, Grain Sales, and all that stuff in your hand. 5-year plan is very bad to hold if you get dealt stuff like that. So we're good holding it at the end of this turn, but we don't want to hold it at the end of turn 3 unless we absolutely have to. But it's kind of hard to think of a scenario where I would have to hold it. I mean, my hand would have to be just terrible, I guess, for that to happen. Even if my hand is terrible, I still want to play it next turn, at the latest. Yeah, I really messed this up right here with Angola and Zaire. I gave him the 2-for-1 coup opportunity. That was a mistake. Thinking about spacing Marshall Plan, but we'll see what happens. gives them an opportunity to go into Venezuela, but Libya is also open too, and he can't take both of them. Also, Algeria and South Korea, of course. Really thinking about just taking Greece and Turkey with Marshall Plan here to secure the Europe domination. Yeah, if I take Greece and Turkey, it'll be 6 to 4. But if I space Marshall Plan, it's not that far away from being 4 to 4. So this really secures my Europe domination. Asia's already looking pretty good, although not perfect. I mean, South Korea is really important here too. If I just put like take Greece and not Turkey, it's pretty much 5 to 5. I guess, I mean, South Korea is still really important, but less so because of the fact that I'm so far ahead on Asia battlegrounds already. I mean, putting 1 point into Egypt gives me Middle Eastern domination too. Guess I could just go 2 in Greece, 1 in Egypt, and 1 in South Korea. Can't believe how good that play was. I can't actually even get domination here anymore. I mean, I could force him to spend one more than... Alright. Wow, brutal. Know if that's worth it. Getting too low on time. I know I could play China card, but the problem with that is it messes up my 5-year plan strategy, because then I'll have 5-year plan and 2 more cards on the last action round, and you know, then it doesn't work. I wouldn't be able to discard a scorecard with the 5-year plan if I play China card before that. So yeah, I don't think I'm going to get Asia domination. In fact, I'm kind of wondering if I should have just played Asia scoring right there. I mean, if he uses 3 ops to flip Vietnam, was that really even worth it? Probably not. I don't know about that play, actually. I think I kind of messed that up, because I'm kind of like backing myself into a corner here where I have to go scorecard space, 5-year plan, you know, just my next 2 turns are, and I can't play China card, like I said, so, man, really disappointed I didn't get Asia domination. Maybe I should have put that last one in Nicaragua, actually, because he really wants to space decolonization here. If he holds decolonization, he's got a chance of being overloaded on bad cards for the next turn. Really wants to space. Oh, he's got UN intervention, I see. Well, I'm glad I didn't put it in Nicaragua now. Double space on this turn would be really nice. I'll play nuclear subs on AR7, hopefully, if everything goes according to plan. Probably end up playing that for ops, because I only have one OPEC country right now. This missile envy's probably gonna get played for ops as well. Well, should I go South America or should I go Italy? Italy's got no adjacency at all. I mean, it's a pretty big threat. Blockade's still on the deck, you know. I mean, I've got realigns. It's a pretty big threat to take Italy here. In fact, I think I'm going to do that. To threaten control. I mean, if I, like, headline something that changes DEFCON to 5 and realign here, that's, like, game over. Well, Europe control anyway. So, hopefully soon game over. You know, I really didn't need to hit that roll to implement that strategy that I was just talking about. I have a +2 on Italy and a +1 on West Germany, so if I can headline something to move DEFCON to 5, I have huge realign opportunities. Thank you. Well, I need to think about Poland overprotection. It's weird that he took one out of Thailand. It seems like kind of a strange choice. Like, is he about to? That play kind of leaves me open for a pope, and I really don't want to play the China card either. Although playing the China card right now wouldn't be that bad. In the mid game, I feel like I don't need to hang on to it as much because there's cards like Nixon, Cultural Revolution, that work better when the China card is in my opponent's hand. Okay, I'm cool with that. I got some adjacency for Zaire. Got back into South Africa. Spread my adjacency a little bit here, so that was a pretty good trade for me. He can't realign me out of Zaire anymore. I mean, it's hard to realign four out of there, but you know, it might be like a secondary target and lucky roll to, and then all of a sudden I don't have any presence at all in South Africa, so yeah. I like spreading out here. I like it. And I should think about putting more in Poland as well. Haven't seen Pope yet. Okay. Really need to think about overprotecting Thailand here too, because this is going to be pretty dangerous with Usuri out. He's got China card over there. Okay. I mean, I don't really want to get Pakistan flipped either. If I make him, if I make him play Usuri and China card to flip Thailand, I still don't like it really. I mean, can I really put five there? I mean, Brush War is gone. I could just. I can't put five there. That's silly, isn't it? Guess I'll just do it like this. Probably gonna coup Venezuela at the beginning here. Got a pretty good hand. Probably use socialist governments for the ops instead of the event because I already have Europe domination pretty locked. Hope a government's event isn't horrible for me here, but I don't want it to go off. Probably going to hold the Camp David space puppet events. And we're up to the third space race box, so whoever gets to the third space race box first is going to have a huge advantage. It's a 4-point swing, whoever hits that first. Even if he's got one small step in his hand and he leapfrogs me after I hit it, you know, that's still a win for me, in my opinion. And there's a pretty decent chance he does have one small step in his hand, so I guess that kind of makes hitting the third box less important than it normally would be, but I mean, there's a pretty good chance he doesn't have it also. Well, that's not a. That is really bad for me. Oh my gosh, what a disaster, 10-pointer. Overprotecting Vietnam and flipping Indonesia might not be a terrible idea here either, with Southeast Asia scoring imminent and Asia scoring teetering on the brink. It's not too much longer before Asia scoring gets shuffled back in at the end of turn six, it looks like. Want to overprotect Angola also, even though we haven't seen Portuguese yet. Kind of feel like the space is a higher priority than all of that stuff, though. Well, let's see what he does here, though. Okay, I still have Africa domination. Looks like a space. I like spacing. Sweet. think it's actually smarter to play Liberation Theology for the two ops here. Now that Central America scoring is gone. Oh, you know what I could have done there? I just realized I could have evented ABM Treaty and realigned in Europe right there. Oh man, I should have thought of that. Shit, it didn't even occur to me to do that. Oh man. Wish I had done that, man. I could have had a plus two here and plus one there. Oh shit, I can still do it, I guess. Wow. I mean, I want to use this to flip Indonesia too, but wow, to do this realign would be crazy. I mean, and I have great secondary realign targets too. Wow. I feel like I should go for the humongous realign here. Disappointing. That went so badly, he's got a huge realign set up in France now. I guess I should have done that last one in Italy, and he would have lost one in Italy, and then he has a worse realign going on in France. Oh, he's not going to do it. Oh, I'm stupid. I should have just used the Che to coup both of those. I forgot that he stepped into Uruguay already. Oh no, I'm dumb. Yeah, I totally forgot he had one in Uruguay there. Wonder if he's trying to bluff. Oh no, wait, I know what all of his cards are. What am I saying? Koo is just good enough to put him in an awkward spot here because he doesn't want to leave this open. He wants the control back, but he can't take the control back and Koo. And War Games is getting shuffled in at the end of turn 7, so I need to keep an eye on that VP track when we get to the end of next turn. Try to keep him under 7 points. had to go for space first because he's got one small step in his hand. Hopefully this works out. He's got a plus one realign here, but that leaves a DEFCON at 5 if he does that. Anything but a 1 would have been nice there. This Truman Doctrine looks pretty dangerous, but his hand is so ops poor that I should be able to just jam a whole bunch in here and get the control back in East Germany and the domination back in Europe. Oh, you know what I forgot East Germany was only a 3. I thought East Germany was a 4, and I needed to put 5 ops in there for to control East Germany. Yeah, this is much better for me then. No, it seems crazy to leave Nigeria open, but it just feels right. Kind of missed my opportunity to step into Argentina too, but I just felt like I never got the opportunity. That's a pretty annoying play for him because he still doesn't have his mill ops, and also he hasn't spaced a card, so he was probably planning on doing one of those two things instead, but now he's kind of forced to deal with this, if he can. Feels weird to do with Middle East scoring in my hand, but I just think it's right. Still got Iranian hostage crisis out. I'm not too mad about taking a minus four in Middle East. If I flip Iran, it's a 4-point swing, but I feel like this was worth more than four. Even though I have that scorecard in my hand, I still feel like that. There's a decent chance we're going to see South America before the end of the game, but not a sure shot, though. I thought about realigning on there. I could have had a plus two in South Africa, but Africa scoring is gone. Or I could have had a plus zero in Chile and just gone for it. Pretty good chance he's got war games here. Ah, that was a tough game. Tough game. I felt like I played pretty well. I guess I made some mistakes. Realign roles didn't work out very well for me. Yeah, so anyway, I still have that game with Quiktics scheduled. I think it starts in almost exactly 12 hours. And then he's going to play in the, I believe it's the semifinals of the OTSL playoffs. Quiktics is. Yeah, he's right. I should have spaced on AR1 there. Although I really didn't have a very good card to space. I guess I should have just space Warsaw. There's such a good chance he's got war games in his hand at the end there. I mean, there's only 19 more cards in the deck, and there's a decent chance that he held it from a previous turn. Yeah, I guess I'm happy with the way I played, even though I could have played better. There were a lot of tough decisions in that game. If you go over it with a fine-tooth comb, you know, you can find mistakes that I made, but I think overall I played pretty well. But yeah, I think that was a pretty clear mistake at the end there. I should have just space Warsaw Pact, you know. I mean, even though it's my own card, this box is just so huge, especially with war games out, you know. I mean, I don't know. I guess I was just kind of screwed. I mean, South America scoring is going to kill me anyway. Yeah, anyway, thanks for watching, and I'm pretty sure we're still playing this game in 12 hours. I think he said in Discord that he still wanted to play it. So I'll be back in about 12 hours.